You gotta prove yourself. You gotta rise up.
College football's most prestigious fraternity welcomes a new member.
Show them who you are, man. Elevate.
The Heisman Trophy Ceremony presented by Nissan. Tonight at 7 on ESPN.
I know it's virtual. I'm just glad that they can hand out this prestigious award tonight.
Again, I'm tempted to touch it.
No.
I'll stay away. Enjoy the Heisman Trophy Ceremony next.
Welcome to the 2020 Heisman Trophy Ceremony, presented by Nissan.
. 2020 is over, and as we take our first steps into the promise of a new year, there's one thing left over from last year that is actually joyful. Even though it's 2021 now, thank God, there's still the 2020 Heisman Trophy to award. Right now, two players from Alabama, one from Clemson, and one Florida Gator are all waiting to hear who will win. It doesn't escape our notice that all four finalists play ball in a geographic tight square that forms the castle keep of college football mania. So it's fitting somehow that in a year when we double down on the essentialness of college football, that the Heisman Trophy will be given out not in New York City, but inside this unhinged, beautiful square. Devontae Smith and Mac Jones, Trevor Lawrence and Kyle Trask. One of them will forever be called a Heisman Trophy winner. But all four are shining examples of what the human will and spirit can accomplish, even in the most troubling of times.
New York City has been home to the Heisman Trophy since its birth in 1935, and the big ceremony returns to the Big Apple next year. But we're all adapting and adjusting and gathering via cameras and screens. And the family of Heisman winners and the four finalists join us from all over. The life-changing announcement remains as powerful as ever. So we shift for this year from Times Square to ESPN Plaza for a very unique Heisman Trophy presentation. And although the feel and the look is certainly unique, what hasn't been unique about this year and this football season? Welcome, I'm Chris Fowler. Just like everybody else, you'll be enjoying this presentation on a screen. But something that has not changed is this award and the power and the weight of the Heisman Trophy. That remains constant, and the man who gets to clutch this at the end of this hour will have that powerful, life-changing experience, and that you cannot take away from him. When you think about what it has taken for all of us to make it through this year and for these players to make it through this season, they embody the qualities that have helped us all not just survive, but also thrive. Toughness, stamina, resilience, resolve, the ability to prepare, to be ready for anything. And then the leadership skills to help anxious teammates through uncertain times. This was not a season about flash. It was about that kind of substance. And we congratulate all four of the Heisman finalists for representing that so well and for inspiring us. The Heisman winner family is gathered from all over the place. And these guys are very eager to welcome in a new club member. There are some who are watching with slightly more interest than others. Got Tim Brown, 87 Heisman Trophy winner from Notre Dame. Tim, of course, was the first receiver to win it, and he, like many of you played the position, feel like maybe it's been long enough without another receiver winning the Heisman Trophy. Steve Spurrier, one of three Gator quarterbacks to win the Heisman, joins us from Gainesville. Steve wore number 11. He's extra proud of this year's Gator number 11, Kyle Trask. And Ty Detmer and Andre Ware join us, just like Barry Sanders right before them. They were not in the room when it happened, when their name was called as Heisman Trophy winners, but they would tell you that has not diminished their Heisman pride or the experience of winning the award one iota. And they can certainly relate to the Heisman finalists here tonight. Now, the timing of the trophy presentation is certainly unique, but the timetable for voting is unchanged. The deadline for the ballots was December 21st, 2 days after the conference championship games. So we got the four finalists in alphabetical order right here. Alabama junior Mac Jones comes from Jacksonville, just like Tide Heisman hero Derrick Henry did. In his spectacular season, Mac was almost flawless in Bama's biggest games. He would be this dynasty's first Heisman quarterback. Mac joins us from Tuscaloosa, where his team just practiced for the championship collision with Ohio State Monday in Miami. Trevor Lawrence has commanded the brightest spotlight in three seasons at Clemson. He won 34 of 36 starts, undefeated in the regular season, made a massive impact on the sport in a year of personal growth on and away from the football field. And Trevor joins us from Clemson, surrounded by his people as well. Devontae Smith was the irresistible force in Alabama's arsenal. The small-town guy from Louisiana created a senior season for the ages, made the reliably spectacular look sort of easy. Devontae could bridge that gap of 28 seasons between Heisman-winning wide receivers. He's just the fourth receiver finalist this millennium. He's also in Tuscaloosa, of course, with trademark fashionable style right there. Kyle Trask made his patience pay off in a record-crushing season for the Gators. The native Texan was the sport's only 4,000-yard passer in a shortened regular season. His 43 touchdowns were 11 more than anyone else. And, of course, Kyle is in Gainesville, joined by his family, and he's going to soon start prepping for the NFL. So the finalists, sadly, cannot share the experience together in New York. Maybe Trevor could have asked Mac what his hometown of Jacksonville is like. But each has a Heisman Trophy standing by, and when one name is read, they'll be able to clutch that trophy and have that Heisman moment, just as Desmond Howard and Tim Tebow did. Our two college football team members are Heisman Trophy winners, and they always bring great energy and perspective this evening, and they join us from their respective homes in Florida. Good evening, guys.
Good evening, Chris. Thanks so much for having us. And, oh, this is so exciting. I got to be honest, I'm not up for the award, but I'm so nervous right now. This is such an incredible time. And Chris, you do an unbelievable job, as always. And since I'm the Gator, let's go from one Gator to another. Kyle Trask, man, you had an unbelievable season. But really what I want to know is you didn't start from 2012 to 2019. Kyle, how did you continue to believe in yourself so much when very few other people did?
It really just started with my family and my friends. You know, they always had that support for me no matter what. You know, they always knew I had that determination in me to, you know, keep going no matter what. And they always had my back. Grateful.
Trevor Lawrence. Hey, Trev, man, you had a great season. But check this out. So you came into the season as the overall favorite to win the Heisman. It's pretty much Trevor Lawrence versus the field. How were you able to manage such huge expectations and all of that pressure throughout the season and still land right here tonight?
Yeah, I think how crazy this year was in general, that was kind of the last thing on my mind was winning the Heisman. So just trying to be a good teammate and play the best I can every week for my team was the main thing, and trying to stay healthy. So with COVID and everything going on. So that was the last thing, was just, you know, living up to the Heisman expectations. But to be here now is a great feeling, and to be in the presence, I guess, in a certain sense, not technically in the presence, but just with these other three guys who had amazing seasons, it's an honor for sure. So I'm glad to be here.
Mac, I got to go to you next. Being my Jacksonville guy, being Duval, same hometown as me, Mac, one of the things that has amazed me about you is the eye of the tiger, is the conviction in which you throw with. And I've watched you in so many pregame warmups, and you throw with the same conviction in pregame warmups on every single throw that you did on the game-winning SEC championship drive. Mac, how has that mindset helped get you to this point?
Yeah, it's definitely just a mindset, like you said, and I got to give credit to all my teammates for instilling that mindset in me. I come out every day and try and work hard, but those guys make this game so much more fun, you know, my teammates and my coaches. So I just got to give credit to them for making me as competitive as I am, and we just got to keep this thing rolling.
Devontae Smith, since I'm a receiver, you're a receiver, I'm going to use your nickname, because Devontae has the coolest nickname of everybody. They call him the Slim Reaper. His teammates say because he's out there on the gridiron snatching bodies and taking souls. So, Devontae, you snatched the soul of Georgia as a true freshman, scoring a game-winning touchdown in the national championship game. What have you done since then to not become a one-catch wonder that has landed you right here as a Heisman finalist tonight?
Just continuing to elevate my game, just being in the film room, going out to practice every day, competing against my teammates. They make me a better player. So with them giving me great looks, I try to do the same thing for them.
All right, well, best of luck, guys. Congratulations, and you can take it from here, CF.
All right, Dez, thanks. Don't believe what those guys tell you if they're not nervous. I mean, everybody's nervous. The winner this year will break a mini streak. The last three Heisman finalists have been transfers. All these three, four guys play for their original school. And for the first time in a couple decades, all Heisman finalists come from schools east of the Mississippi. We'll meet them beginning right after this.
Good evening. Although college football may look and feel a lot different this year, there is no shortage of incredible talent on the gridiron. One thing the pandemic cannot suppress is the persevering spirit of a true winner, and the Trust is eager to celebrate the 2020 Heisman Trophy winner. The Trust's mission is to preserve the integrity of the Heisman Trophy and provide financial support to worthy charities. Our charitable mission is made possible by the generous and acceptance insurance. On behalf of the Trust, thank you, stay healthy, stay safe.
Hi, my name is Roger Staubach.
Hi, this is Kyler Murray.
This is Herschel Walker.
This is Baker Mayfield.
Congratulations to this year's finalists.
The Heisman
is a special fraternity.
We have a special group of guys.
And tonight
is a night you'll remember forever.
Enjoy the ceremony.
And go Gators.
Go Sooners.
Roll Tide.
The 2020 Heisman Trophy Ceremony is presented by Nissan. Visit theheismanhouse.com and get in the game.
We thank the parents for delivering all those adorable childhood photos. It's a virtual gathering, but of course the very real journeys all four of these finalists took is worth celebrating. And as the wise philosopher Drake said, the journey teaches you much about the destination. Kyle Trask's journey has been absolutely unique in the history of Heisman Trophy finalists. For starters, he went about 6 years between starts. Perseverance, resilience, and powerful belief led him to fulfill his lifelong vision. For kindergarten career day, Kyle declared, "I want to be a football player." Just like his grandpa Orville, a 6'4 tackle and captain of the Houston Oilers. He had to learn patience and develop team devotion at Manville High School. Supremely talented classmate De'Eric King was the starter, and Kyle a 3-year backup. So scholarship offers were scarce. The Gators were the only major program to spot the talent in Trask. He was handed the number of Heisman legend Steve Spurrier. But at first, it was no fairy tale at Florida. Team turmoil and injuries meant 3 more years of waiting, but never wavering. Kyle ignored advice to transfer, trusting his gut, seizing his chance when it finally arrived last season. Faith and total trust remain essential tools for Trask. Those endless reps in practice created rare chemistry and clarity. And using the Gators' gifted arsenal, Kyle was almost flawless in his choices and checks. His connection with tight end Kyle Pitts was unreal.
He just threaded the needle on a touchdown pass to Kyle Pitts.
Pitch and catch precision at a Sunday level. To Trask, the signature moment was a staggering onslaught against arch rival Georgia after Florida fell down 14-0.
Here's Trask on play action. Got a wide open receiver. Touchdown! Oh, my! And what a game today in Jacksonville.
Another one of Kyle's 400-yard games came against Alabama, and Nick Saban, not known for lavish praise, had this to say: "I have a lot of respect for guys that stick with it, persevere, overcome a lot of adversity, go through a lot of learning and growing pains. Kyle has certainly done that, and he has had as fine a season as anybody in the country." And Maria, Kyle really is an inspiration for all the guys out there who have waited and wondered, will I ever get my chance to prove myself?
Well, he represents, like Coach Saban said, everything you want to see in college football, and he's surrounded by his support system now in Dan Mullen, mom and dad, Melissa and Michael, the old ball coach, and Danny Werfel. But Kyle, I want to start with you because we got a couple of people that are really excited to show their support. Your teammates decided to log on a surprise Zoom. They wanted to get a couple gator chomps in, a couple of high fives and claps. What has this team meant for you and the perseverance that you've shown to stick with them through your entire four seasons at Georgia or at Florida?
I mean, this team means everything to me. Just in the past 5 years here have been unreal. I mean, to go from, you know, sitting on the sidelines for that long to where I am now, it's unbelievable. And to have the memories and the friendships that I made here, you know, I'll never forget it.
Well, it's incredible because Melissa, your mom, told me that you were living your dream, and it's been inspiring to her. How would you describe, Melissa, what you've seen from your son over the course of his college career?
Tremendous growth and just a passion. He's getting to live his dream, like you said. His perseverance, and he's grown so much as a man. The man he's turned in is just amazing. Staying grounded, just calm. I mean, it's just amazing to see this all play out before my eyes. Very proud mom.
Well, and obviously the man he comes to be hopefully resembles a lot like dad, and that's Michael. What's it been like for you and your son to go through this together? And I know how proud you are of him and how you've been there since the very beginning.
Oh, it's been a wonderful journey to watch him grow both academically and athletically, and just coming from such having to overcome such adversity and just keep going, keep grinding, never complaining, just keep on going. It's been a very proud moment to watch him.
Never complaining, Coach. It must be nice to have someone like that. I mean, Dan Mullen here with us, and he's the guy that actually had that quarterback on his sideline who waited his turn. As a coach, what was it like to even have him in the locker room, to have him as a leader throughout these seasons?
Well, you know what? Since the first day I stepped on campus, you know, Kyle's just been a guy that every day gave you everything he had. He showed up. He prepared for every single game. He was a tremendous leader in the offseason, all through the programs, all through practice, in everything he did. And you know what? I mean, a guy that kept competing and competing and competing. And you know what? It, when his opportunity came about and he got that moment and that opportunity to step on the field, you know what? To see him go succeed is so special. He's meant so much to this team, not just this year, over the last several years. And the personality and the character that he brings to the program is so special. And for everyone to go out there and learn, if you continue to work, you continue to work. And then he got his opportunity. And I'll tell you what, he took the most of it. And it shows what I was doing of keeping him on the sidelines next to me all that time right there. But when he got his opportunity, it meant so much to this program, meant so much to this team, and had such a special season this year.
Yeah, well, Coach, he's made you look good since you put him in and since he's taken over that starting role. The SEC East champs, the Florida Gators, Kyle Trask, congratulations on a great season. Everything that you've represented for college football, good luck moving forward, and good luck tonight. Chris?
Maria, thanks. We salute Kyle and all the finalists who are graduates, and it's been very cool to watch all of their personal growth in the last few years. As the Heisman Brotherhood welcomes a new member tonight, they also remember a friend they lost in November. Paul Hornung was an astounding athlete. He led Notre Dame in passing, rushing, scoring, punting, also played defense. So valuable that he won the 56th Heisman on a 2-8 team. In Green Bay, he starred on 5 championship teams and was MVP. When the Army called Hornung to active duty, Vince Lombardi arranged weekend passes, and Paul set the NFL scoring record that season. Hornung was called the Golden Boy, a magnetic national celebrity. He sought fun everywhere and found it, and leaves behind a long and complex legacy in his 84 years. Tonight, his fellow Heisman brothers would like to join us in a salute. The 1956 winner and very loyal member of the fraternity, Paul Hornung. Gentlemen.
Not even Kyler was intuitive enough to expect what would unfold this football season. Welcome back to the ESPN campus, home of the 2020 Heisman presentation, 5 days into 2021. Pass winners joining us on screens, eager to see the new member of this club in about 20 minutes, the 86th Heisman Trophy winner. Now, this is really exciting for us. Next year, the Heisman Trophy ceremony returns to New York City in a brand new, exciting venue. Jazz at Lincoln Center's Frederick P. Rose Hall. We're supposed to host the ceremony this year. That was plan A, but we certainly look forward to the intimate, elegant setting on the edge of Columbus Circle in Central Park next year. The Empire State Building in Midtown Manhattan, always lit up. It's got Christmas colors for the moment, but later tonight, they'll honor the colors, the uniform of this year's Heisman Trophy winner. So have the crimson or the orange light bulbs standing by. In April 2018, I went to Clemson's spring game to see all the hype about this freshman quarterback. It took about 10 seconds to see that Trevor Lawrence would leave a very special legacy in this sport. With the fewer athletes, it's that obvious. And Trevor had it and then went about building upon it with relentless passion the last three seasons.
Trevor grew up in Knoxville, Tennessee, and naturally chose volunteer legend Peyton Manning as a role model. His family moved to North Georgia, and Trevor quickly blossomed into one of the most hyped high school quarterbacks ever for the Cartersville Canes. Clemson became his clear choice, a place to pursue his bold goal of being the best QB ever. From the start, he looked the part, picking apart Alabama for the national title. In his sophomore season, the Tigers were dethroned and Trevor denied a second ring. But 2020 brightened in July when girlfriend Marissa Mowry accepted his engagement ring. Summer also brought turmoil. Lawrence used his influential voice to call for racial justice and unity. With the football season in doubt, he lobbied and led the chorus to let the games go on. Trevor's gifts are obvious to all at first glance. The extraordinary looked easy. Surgery on Nick Saban's defense as a true freshman, it seemed an impossible standard, but Lawrence was relentlessly superb throughout his 40-game Clemson career. He withstood violent blows as college football's largest target and wore his toughness as a cherished badge. When the most gifted embrace the grind, deflect the glory, elevate teammates by their example, very rare legacies like Lawrence's are burned into the hard drive of history.
People love to have the GOAT conversation, and many believe that Trevor is in that conversation when it comes to college quarterbacks, including the defensive coordinator at Ohio State, who says he does so many things very well, one of the best college football quarterbacks of all time. In a season in which three of the top five prospects opted out before the season for various reasons, and then some opted out during the season, some before the bowl game, Maria, Trevor had the most to lose of all of them, yet he never wavered.
Yeah, and in fact, he ended up being the focal point and the face of the We Want to Play Move It. And Trevor Lawrence joining us now from Clemson. And Trevor, it's so interesting because we were there when you won a national championship as a freshman, and we've seen how much you've taken on off the field. How would you describe the legacy that you're trying to leave, the leader that you're trying to be throughout your career at Clemson?
Yeah, I think one thing is something I hear all the time being at Clemson from Coach Sweeney is to live your legacy, not to try to leave it. So these 3 years that I've been here, I've just tried to come in and be my best every day and take things head on as they come. And there's been a lot of adversity, I guess, this year with everything going on. And I feel like just my main thing is just to treat people right and just be good to people. And, you know, kind of those things fall in line with the social justice that we want to play. Obviously, that affected a lot more people than just me. And we all have a passion for football and kind of came together and came up with something. And, you know, obviously this season has been unique and different, but it's been a lot of fun. I know a lot of guys are appreciative of just having a season. I know I am. So it's been an awesome year, a crazy ride, but it's been a whole lot of fun.
Amanda and Jeremy, mom and dad, it must be extraordinary to sit next to a young man who's as poised as your son is. And since he was a 10th grader, basically in high school, the spotlight's been on him. What have you learned from him? What have you seen in him over the course of the last 3 years?
Well, I would say that, you know, Trevor definitely has a God-given talent and that he has really cultivated his craft and used it for good and impacted a lot of people with it.
And, Dad, I'd love to hear from you, too, on what you've seen from your son and the way that he's been able to lead, not only on the field, but what he's taken on off the field.
Well, it's just been a joy to watch him from a young age, his passion and love for the game, all the hard work and sacrifice, and being able to pick the university and the program that really fit him and go to that environment and really thrive and flourish on and off the field, and just really proud of the man he's become.
Absolutely. It's been impressive. And Dabo Sweeney, not many people could probably be prouder than you as a coach. And we sat at the ACC Championship afterwards, and you said, it'd be a crying shame if the Heisman didn't attach their name to Trevor Lawrence. And here we sit with Trevor as a finalist. What does he not only mean to Clemson, but also to college football at large over the course of his career?
Well, I just think he represents everything that's great about college football. And he's been such an ambassador, not just for this team, but for everyone, you know, a standard of excellence, a commitment to excellence on and off the field, a graduate in 3 years. He's been the same guy from the first time I met him, an incredibly humble spirit. He's demonstrated to everyone in college football, you know, how to, you know, use your platform. You can be great, but you can be humble in doing it. And that's what I'm most proud of. I mean, he's 34-2. He's an unbelievable winner. Nobody's ever done it better. But it's how he's won. It's how he's handled the expectations, the bright lights, to me, that I think will be a lasting legacy for a lot of young men throughout college football and high school football that I think have an opportunity to learn from him.
Real quick, Trevor, are you more nervous now or when you got down on one knee to propose to Marissa, who's sitting right next to you?
Definitely more nervous to propose, but I'm still pretty nervous.
All right, Chris, take it away.
Yeah, Dabo said it well. The commitment and courage off the field to use that platform. And you know it might attract critics, but you also know it's the right thing in your heart. Congratulations to you two. Big things ahead for the Lawrence family. I want to congratulate both Colby Orcutt of Fort Walton Beach, Florida, and Graham Tuigedos of Lakewood, Colorado, the 2020 recipients of the Heisman High School Scholarships presented by Acceptance Insurance. Well done. Big sports week here on ESPN. Clippers and the Warriors highlight our NBA doubleheaders on Wednesday and Friday. Steph Curry is back, by the way. The Titans take on the Ravens in our wild card game on Sunday. And then, of course, Monday night from Miami, Alabama and Ohio State meet in the national championship game presented by AT&T. Prominently featured in that game, Heisman finalists Devontae Smith and Mac Jones of the Crimson Tide. We will talk to them as we count down to the big announcement here at ESPN.
The 2020 Heisman Trophy Ceremony is presented by Nissan, premier partner of the Heisman Trophy.
Well, we salute the golden and silver anniversary Heisman winners, also NFL legends, James William Plunkett, Edward Nathan George Jr., you can call him Jim and Eddie. Guys, congratulations. We can all hug it out next year. By the way, Eddie, your record just fell, 25-year-old record, broken by Trey Sermon, but he's pumped up that the Buckeyes' ground game is churning into Miami. Well, Thursday, we'll have the 30th annual Home Depot College Football Award Shows, basically all the awards besides the Heisman. Reese Davis hosts from right here in the studio, along with Holly Rowe, 7 Eastern, also on the ESPN app. Solid, not special. That recruiting label meant that Mac Jones had sort of modest choices until Alabama was wowed by his breakout summer camp performance and flipped him from Kentucky. But Mac wondered, would he be just another guy in talent-rich Tuscaloosa? At first, he was. Just 13 passes in his forced 14 appearances. But in season 4 with the Tide, Mac took command as pilot of Bama's best offense ever. Quite a transformation.
Matt grew up a Jacksonville Beach kid and a jokester from the beginning, the youngest of three and center of attention, always happy, making everyone smile. Encouraged to try everything, Matt got into music, acting, and modeling, which helped develop memorization skills and footwork. Father Gordon, Mother Holly, and older siblings Will and Sarah Jane were all college athletes. Matt dove into various sports too, but a passion for football and early skills slinging the pigskin a long way made his choice easy. Jones arrived at Bama somewhat in the shadows and waited, watching, laboring, and learning, first from Jalen Hurts, then Tua Tagovailoa. Mac has earned two college degrees with a straight A GPA. He credits consistent grinding more than natural gifts.
Mac looks, end zone, touchdown! Wow!
Jones preps like an NFL vet, adjusts nimbly on the fly, even as a first-year starter, brings contagious calm to the huddle. It takes moxie to lead the many alphas at Alabama, and Mac is poised, precise in the pocket. His signature deep ball daggers, slicing defenses to pieces with astounding accuracy. That's even better than the prodigy who preceded him.
Check out the numbers on passes thrown more than 20 yards downfield. Those elite deep plays are what separate teams, and he was second in completion percentage, 14 touchdowns on the deep balls. The yards per attempt, absolutely off the charts. So much for solid, but not special. Maria, teammates call him the Joker. He's got kind of a quirky laugh. It admits he's kind of an eccentric cat walking around talking to himself at the football complex.
Well, either way you slice it, Chris, since Mac Jones was a kid, he's known exactly where he was supposed to be. Check this out. When he was 7 years old, he wrote a letter saying that he wanted to be an NFL player. And guess what? Now he sits in the Heisman Trophy finalist section of the schoolyard, and that's on his way to still completing that dream, obviously. He wrote that in 2005, and now Mac Jones joining me now. And I see the family. They're looking nice. They're here to support you, Mac, but I want to start with that childhood dream. You've always known that you wanted to make it to the pros. Did you expect that that would involve a stop at the Heisman Trophy finalist ceremony?
Yeah, I mean, I've always had a dream just to play college football and to have an attempt to win a national championship. So I'm just blessed to be at the University of Alabama, and a lot of people have told me along my journey that I'd never make it, and I just kind of put my head down and went to work and had help from a lot of great people.
You know, I spoke to your parents, and your mom, Holly, was telling me about how you itemized your playbooks, how you would actually do throwing practice in your apartment. How did you prepare for this season, and how did it allow you to have the performance that we've been able to watch on your way to a national championship game?
Yeah, I think preparation is a big thing for me. You know, just not being the most athletic guy, I just have to kind of rely on my preparation and see things before they happen, and then get the ball to the players around me. But it's really just preparation. In practice, in the film room, at the indoor, wherever I need to get it, it just comes from that.
You know, Mac, you're another one of those extraordinary stories in perseverance. What would you say to a young kid maybe that's kind of waiting their turn, that isn't a starter yet, but they need that opportunity? What would that your advice be to them?
Yeah, I'd say for anybody, just pursue your dream and don't let anybody tell you that you can't do something, because along the road, if you love something and you put your heart to it, you should be able to do it, and don't let anybody tell you no.
Well, you're living proof of that, and we will certainly enjoy continuing to watch you on this ride and in the national championship. Obviously, Mac Jones preparing in Tuscaloosa. Mom Holly, Dad Gordon, and his sister Sarah Jane, they're all hanging out too, and obviously being supportive. Brother Will, he even dressed up for us today. So good luck, Mac, the rest of the night.
Thank you.
It's special to share an evening like this, not just with a teammate, but a classmate. When you come in the same recruiting class to a place like Alabama, which is the deepest end of the pool, you have that holy bleep moment. Then you try to adjust and lean on each other, and certainly Devontae and Mac did that. You know, Jones to Smith, what could not sound more generic could not actually be more dynamic. Devontae may line up on the edge most of the time, but he was the central focus for almost all the opponents, and they still couldn't slow him down. At wide receiver U, Smith grew from protege to mentor to legend, the all-time Alabama leader in receiving yards.
Devontae was born and raised in tiny Amite, Louisiana. To family, he was simply Tay,
the kid who was always smiling and shining, a phenom at whatever sport he tried, football, track, basketball. Check his soaring dunks at 6'1". Devontae led the AME Warriors to the 3A state championship game. The five-star recruit chose the Crimson Tide, arriving in Tuscaloosa with classmates Tua Tagovailoa and Mac Jones. Pushed by a stellar receiving core, Smith made a massive splash to cap his rookie season with a ring.
Fire to the end zone! Touchdown! Alabama wins! True freshman to true freshman.
Devontae's personality emerged through his fresh style, tailored suits, and fly bow ties. The look is meticulous and mirrors his methods on the field.
I don't care who watching, I'ma do my dance like, hey!
To teammates, he is Smitty. Still skinny, but so savvy. Mac Jones calls him his co-pilot. Devontae sees all and knows all, a tactician and technician. He seems two moves ahead of defenders. Number six is plenty fast, but extremely smooth, with long arms, soft hands, quiet toughness, and fierce competitive drive to play his best against the best.
Check out the performances in Bama's biggest games. Wow. Not to mention three more touchdowns versus Notre Dame after the voting closed. It was number one in yards after the catch, a bunch more catches and yards than anyone else in the country. At 98 catches with only two drops. And Maria, that is A++ grade for the season.
You're right, Chris. And I can tell you a place where they're super excited to see those numbers go up. How about AME, Louisiana, the hometown of Devontae Smith, where it's about a town of 2,400. How about 125 of them socially distant, wearing their mask and having a watch party at the community center? And that's where we find mom, Christina. And I got to ask you, what has it been like to see the community rally around your son and his performances all season long?
It's been amazing. We all have enjoyed the ride. Devontae has been tremendous to the community. Everyone has been behind him, supporting him from day one, and we're just enjoying it.
All right, now, Dad Kelvin, listen, Christina already told me that she was the loud fan, and you were the one that sat in the back and watched and maybe gave your feedback a little bit later. But what's it been like to watch your son rise to this occasion this season?
Well, first and foremost, it's a blessing to be here. To watch our son one of the greatest rewards in college football. He always listened. He always did what we asked him to do. And now he's going to be a nice young man.
Well, Devontae, I've got to get your response to seeing all the community support behind your mom and dad as they all wait and watch and listen to this Heisman Trophy finalist celebration. Devontae, can you hear Maria?
Yes, ma'am.
What's it like to see all of your friends and family waiting to hear whether or not you're going to win a Heisman Trophy this year?
It means a lot to me just knowing that the community has backed me up since I made my decision to come to the University of Alabama, and they've been with me every step of the way.
Well, thank you so much for joining us, Devontae. We love the style because we knew you were going to come with something special. So the burgundy suit is great. Now we welcome in your head coach, Nick Saban. And coach, I know you already had practice today, but it's the eighth time in Heisman history that there are multiple players from the same team that are finalists. How would you describe the way you've seen Mac and Devontae grow throughout this season?
Well, I think for all the folks out there that have young people who are looking for somebody to emulate, these two guys have probably done it as well as anybody that I've ever had the opportunity to coach. They're first-class people. They're great competitors. They set a great examples as leaders. And they've just done a great job in our community, representing our university, and they're great ambassadors in every way, shape, and form for the program. So these are the greatest young men that anybody could ever have the opportunity to emulate.
Well, thank you, Coach, so much for joining us. And great praise from Coach Saban for his players tonight, Chris.
Thank you, Maria. Najee Harris, running back, also had a Heisman-worthy type finalist season, and he finished fifth, so tremendous talent on that roster. We're counting down to the announcement, and then live college basketball, the Tar Heels and the Miami Hurricanes from the ACC at 8 o'clock Eastern time. One final timeout, and then we'll find out who will join this wall of Heisman Trophy winning portraits. The winners joining us live from their homes to welcome in the new member. All of them looking sharp. Wi-Fi is holding up. And the big announcement is now just minutes away.
Like nearly everything in the late and unlamented 2020, many parts of tonight's Heisman ceremony have been different. There have been no grand arrivals, no adoring fans, no press conferences or photo ops. There's no standing ovation from a room full of past champions. This year, though, they have something that just might be better. Each other. The Heisman Trophy has always been won, not by a single player on a single night, but by all the people in their past who breathe their dreams into existence. If there's a time, if there's a place, the time is now
to find our saving grace. I'm more than fine. Start the show, Mac Jones. I'm here today.
The past is a complicated idea. Our recent past has threatened important things like family and silly things like trophies and games. It seems like 10 years ago that Joe Burrow won this award and gave his heartfelt speech.
You took a chance on me, not knowing if I could play or not. He just means so much to me and my family.
But the past also offers the promise that things will once again be normal, and that in times of crisis and fear, we will find a way forward with our families, with our brothers and sisters in arms, with each other.
We thank Wright Thompson for the eloquence of his words, and we thank all four Heisman finalists for inspiring us with their example, their substance in this difficult and challenging season. But there can only be one name to join the roster of Heisman Trophy winners. We hope you've enjoyed the journey here tonight. From the 50s, Pete Dawkins. From the 60s, we have John Hewitt, Mike Garrett, and Steve Spurrier with us. From the 70s, Golden Anniversary winner Jim Plunkett, Johnny Rogers, Archie Griffin, the only two-time winner, Earl Campbell, and Billy Sims. From the 80s, George Rogers, Herschel Walker, Mike Brogier, Doug Flutie, Tim Brown, Andre Ware. From the 90s, Ty Detmer, Desmond Howard, Gino Toretta, Silver Anniversary winner Eddie George, Danny Werfel, and Ricky Williams. And from the 2000s, the era of quarterbacks, we got Chris Winkie, Eric Crouch, Matt Leinart, Troy Smith, and Tim Tebow. Guys all smiles. Some of those guys are actually nervous too. And the journeys from kids to finalists, the Heisman Trophy winner, will now be complete in just seconds. And joining us here to make the announcement, please welcome Heisman Trophy trustee Ann Donahue. Ann, the floor and the envelope is yours.
Thank you, Chris. I'm grateful for the opportunity to announce the 2020 Heisman Trophy winner. Congratulations to the finalists, Mac Jones, Trevor Lawrence, Devontae Smith, and Kyle Trask. In a season that almost wasn't, you brought distraction, hope, and inspiration, lifting spirits during a very dark time. And to the winner, be mindful that you will become a member of the most elite athletic fraternity in the world, that your name will forever be associated with the legacy of being a Heisman Trophy winner. And now, without further ado, the 2020 winner of the Heisman Trophy is Devontae Smith of the University of Alabama.
And thank you very much. Devontae, congratulations. The feel of this is a little bit different, but we'd like to invite you to pick up that beautiful 25-pound Heisman Trophy, which is very near you. Get the feel of it for the first time, and then the floor is yours for your remarks. In the 28-year drought between wide receiving winners of the Heisman Trophy, from Desmond Howard to Devontae Smith, is now over. Devontae, all yours.
First off, I would like to thank God. Without him, none of this would be possible. Congratulate all the finalists. Just to be in this situation with you guys, y'all are great athletes, and just to be a part of something like this is truly a blessing. I want to thank my family, my mom, my dad, just everything that y'all taught me to mold me into the young man I am today. I want to thank my mentor, Vincent Sanders. Without you, I wouldn't be where I am today, just from the rise to taking me places that I want to visit, just to doing things and just helping me get to where I am. I want to thank Coach Saban for giving me the opportunity to come play at the University of Alabama. Thank Coach Wiggins, my receiver coach, just for helping me day in and day out, watching film, making me a better player. Thank my teammates. With team success comes individual success, so without y'all, I wouldn't be where I am today, winning this award. And just to all the young kids out there that's not the biggest, not the strongest, just keep pushing, because I'm not the biggest. I've been doubted a lot just because of my size. And really, it just comes down to you put your mind to it, you can do it. No job is too big. If you put your mind to it, you can do it, and just keep believing in God, and you'll get where you want to be. I would like to thank Jeff Allen and the athletic training staff here for giving me all the resources to continue playing this game, to keep me healthy so I can go out there and do the things that I like to do. Thank our president, Dr. Bell, and our athletic director, Mr. Burns, just for being here and making everything possible with COVID going on and giving us a chance to play this season. Thank you. Roll Tide.
Devontae, thank you very much. They are thrilled in Amite, Louisiana. They've been nervous, no doubt, for the last hour at the watch party. But they got the announcement that they wanted to hear. I wanted to talk to you. We spoke on the phone a couple days ago. I said, just in case you have a speech ready, you said you didn't really have one ready, but like everything else, you proved to be a very quick study. Your message was great. You were, what, maybe about 160 pounds or so when you showed up at the campus of Tuscaloosa. So to all those who have been told you're not quite this, not quite that, it's quite a journey from A-meet to Heisman Trophy winner.
It's just unbelievable. Just coming from a small place like that, you just really have to work day in and day out and just believe in yourself. And if don't nobody else believe you, you just have to believe in yourself and just prove everybody wrong.
We also talked the other day about the power of the collective. You get to that school and it's wide receiver you. You've got Calvin Ridley and Jerry Jeudy and Henry Ruggs. The wide receiver room is unbelievable. Talk about how you guys pushed each other and how those mentors help you get here to this moment.
It's just a family. Just when you got here, everybody was on the same mission to become the best player that they can be, and everybody helped each other in a different way. And just being around those guys, they've taught me so much, just from things on the field to off the field, and they just guided me to where I am today, and I'm so thankful for them.
So the folks from A-Meet, you paid tribute to them. Some of those folks are probably mad when you didn't choose LSU. Your high school colors and the uniforms look just like the Bayou Bengals, but you also thank them for their support. What does it mean to have all those folks gather to be able to share long distance in this moment with you?
It means a lot. Just some of those people have seen me since I was a little kid playing youth football, youth basketball, just seeing me come up, and just they've been there every step of the way. Even when I decided to come here, some of them, they still decided to just follow my journey and just be there with me every step of the way.
Once again, congratulations. We know this was another practice day of preparation for the national championship game. Look forward to seeing you and Mac Jones down there in Miami. Maria, let's take a look at some of the moments there. The moment when it becomes real after all this surreal season, a hug with Mac Jones. A moment's hesitation and disbelief from the front row in a meet.
It's incredible, isn't it, Chris?
As Monte said, they shared in every step of the journey. They were no doubt a lot more nervous than he was watching this last hour unfold.
It's incredible to just watch that happening. And in a meet, obviously in the community center, you could see the excitement definitely overflowing. I know that there are watch parties taking place in other homes. And yes, you are still clapping as you guys should be, but I got to talk to Mom Christina. And in a normal world, you'd be able to be there with your son. You'd be able to hug him and to hold him. What do you want him to know? What do you want to tell him in this moment?
That we love him. Everybody here is supporting him. We're so proud of him. So continue being humble, let God lead him, and we are here to support him every step of the way.
And you guys will no doubt be there every single step of the way. And Kelvin, your son, a great message about what it means to be counted out, but then to rise to the occasion. How would you describe what it feels like in this moment to be the father of a Heisman Trophy winner?
Well, it's the greatest blessing. You know, he's been the best thing that probably could ever happen to me. You know, he's been there for me. I've been there for him. If I needed something, he was able, he had me. And I always told him, no matter what he got going on, I got his back no matter what.
And Christina, what do you want to say to everyone that's behind you, the support that you and your family have received over the course of this entire journey for Devontae?
I would just like to tell my community, Butler Town, I love y'all. Tangipahoa Parish, I love y'all. Just continue to be behind us. I know they will. They've been here from day one. Amy High, Alabama, we love you, Devontae, and Roll Tide.
Extraordinary to see, Chris, what can happen when a community supports a family and how they can be represented in one individual.
No doubt, Maria. And again, Devontae carries himself with such humility that all those folks have to be proud. All four of the Heisman Trophy finalists certainly did that. We can show you the results page. It wasn't really very close. The margin, almost 700 points between Devontae Smith and Trevor Lawrence. Devontae having more than double the number of first place votes. Mac Jones finishing third, Kyle Trask fourth, and again, Alabama running back Najee Harris coming in fifth. Trevor Lawrence was the winner of the Nissan fan vote, by the way. And Devontae Smith, with this season that was such a statistical outlier, compelled Heisman voters to break the almost three-decade hold in this award that running backs and quarterbacks had had. Again, the first since Desmond Howard at the receiver position to win this since 1991, and only the fourth ever third Alabama player to win since 2009. You think that almost a decade ago, just about a decade ago, Alabama had not had a Heisman winner. Now they've had three of them. Again, we hope you've enjoyed this exceptional, unique Heisman Trophy presentation in this unique college football season. We've enjoyed sharing it with you. We also look forward to getting back to New York in 2021. Up next on ESPN, ACC college basketball as the North Carolina Tar Heels visit the Miami Hurricanes. Heisman Trophy night from here at the Bristol campus, from Tuscaloosa, and from A-Meet, Louisiana, a night they will never forget in that small town. And Devontae Smith, a Heisman Trophy winner forever, a life-changing moment, and also an equation-changing moment for the trophy. Many believed a receiver wouldn't be able to ever win this thing again. So much for that. Congratulations, Devontae Smith, winner of the 2020 Heisman. College Hoops coming up right now.